Hello everyone, and welcome to my channel. In today's video I'm going to show you how we can control multiple digital outputs in the Arduino board. As an example, I'm going to show you how we can make these four LED here to blink all together. Stay with me, and let's get started. Okay, just to recap, in the last video, I showed you how to control a single digital output in the Arduino board, which was to blink an LED connected to pin 13. And coming back here in the code, we used the pin mode function to configure pin 13 as output, and then we used the digital write function to turn the LED on and off. We were using the digital write function to turn this LED on and off, but now, to be able to control multiple digital outputs, we will need to edit the internal registers of the Arduino. Firstly, I will quickly show you which are these registers and which pins they configure so that you can have a big picture of the process. Okay, in the Arduino board, as we have seen, the pins from 0 to pin 13 can be configured as digital inputs or outputs, and the registers that configure these pins as input or output are called DDR registers. There are two main groups of DDR registers. The first group is called DDRB, and it configures the pins from pin 8 to 13, as you can see here. So, it is a register that has 6 memory positions, and the least significant bit will configure the pin 8, and the most significant bit will configure the pin 13. We also have the DDRD, which is the register that will configure the pins from 0 to 7. The least significant bit corresponds to the pin 0, and the most significant bit to pin 7. If all of this sounds confusing to you, don't worry, stay with me for a little bit until we get to the code programming. What you need to get from this explanation is that there are two registers. One called DDRB, and it configures the pins from 8 to 13. And the other is the DDRD, which configures the pins from 0 to 7. When I put in this register the binary value 0, I am configuring that pin as input. And when I put the value 1, I am configuring the pin as output. So, this DDR register has the same function as the pin mode, that is, it will define if the pins will be digital input or output. We also have another register called port B and port D, which will configure the voltage on the pins. In the case of port B, it corresponds to the pins from 8 to 13, and the port D to the pins from 0 to 7. They have the same function as the digital write command. If in the port B register, the binary value 0 is inserted, the corresponding pin will have 0 volts. And if it has the binary value 1, the pin will have 5 volts. In principle, all I have presented so far was simply to give the details about how it works internally. Now, let's go to our code. Before we start programming our code, let's first make the connections of our circuit. The main idea is to make each one of the LED to blink at the same time. So, I will need 4 resistors to limit the current of each LED. We will first rotate these resistors one by one to put them on the horizontal. And then, we are going to connect each resistor on the cathode of each LED. Okay, we're also going to connect the resistor terminals on the ground pin. Remember that I already made the connection of the ground pin with this line of connections on the breadboard, and I already made the connection of the 5 volts on the line of connections below. Let's keep all the wires connected to the ground with the black color. And look, we have a new update on the software interface that allows us to change the color of the wire. So, the anode of each LED will be connected on the pins between 8 and 11. Let's make the connections of the anode of each LED with each pin on the Arduino. Let's also adjust the wires to make it easier to visualize the connections with the pins. And we are going to keep the color of the wire green. Now that all connections were made, let's go to the code section. Here in our code, we are going to need to configure the pins as digital output. Based on that, we are going to use the DDR type B, which is the one that controls the pins from 8 to 13. We just type DDR B equals to B, because the values we are going to insert here are binary values. And then, we type 1, 6 times. By doing that, we are configuring the pins from 8 to 11 to be digital outputs. Notice that the register has 6 values that correspond to the pins from 8 to 13. So, when I put the number 1 in all positions of the register, I am configuring the pins from 8 to 13 as digital outputs. However, if I change the first digit on the left to 0, what I'm doing is, I am configuring the pins from 8 to 12 to be digital outputs, which correspond to all these 5 positions here. And the pin 13, it would be configured as a digital input because I inserted the value 0. Now, let's go to the void loop function, which is where we are going to control the LED blink. In the void loop, I am going to type port B equals to B. Then, I type the binary value 1, 6 times. By doing that, I'm sending 5 volts to all pins that I've configured as output. After that, I'm going to wait for half second using the command delay. And then, I'm going to turn off the LED by using the port register again. But now with the binary value 0. And finally, I'm going to wait for another half second by using the command delay. So, in summary, what our code is doing is, it is configuring the pins as output by using the DDR register. That is why I typed 1 in all positions. And in the void loop, I am using the port register, which is the register that commands the voltage level at the pins. Okay. Let's close our code section and start the simulation. Notice that each LED is blinking at the same time. This was only possible by using the DDR register that configures the pins as input or output, and the port register that controls the voltage level on the pins. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If so, give us your feedback and let us know what else you'd like to learn about Arduino. If you have any questions or if we missed any details that were not clear, let us know. We'll try to make more videos clarifying these details. Until next time. Thank you. And see you around.